Good morning and welcome to the Deliverance Time broadcast, sponsored by the members and friends of Eccles Assembly. We are located at lots 57 to 59 Public Road, Eccles, on the east bank of the Morava. I am your radio pastor and friend, Michael Pereira, inviting you to stay tuned for inspiring music and a timely message from the Word of God. Father, we thank you for being present with us this morning. We thank you for every listener tuned to this Deliverance Time broadcast. We are confident that you will minister to us in special ways through the songs and the ministry of your word. So just have your way as we continue to wait in your presence this morning. In Jesus' name we ask it. Amen.
your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us.
You came from
my joy to welcome you once more to this week's edition of the Deliverance Time broadcast, sponsored by the members and friends of Eccles Assembly of God. Eccles Assembly is located at Lots 57 to 59 Public Road, Eccles, right here on the east bank of Demerara. We'll meet at 8:15 this morning for Sunday school. And again, please be reminded that Sunday school is not just for children. We have a class for all ages. Our fellowship service begins at 9:30 this morning, and this is a hybrid event, in-house and online. So just in case you are unable to join us physically, you can connect with us on our Facebook page. That's the Eccles Assembly of God Facebook page for our fellowship service this morning, beginning at 9:30. Tuesday, Lord willing, at 10 in the morning, we'll have our Deliverance Miracle Service. Then on Wednesday at 6:30 in the evening, we have our Bible study. Again, this will be a hybrid event, in-house and online. Remember to write and share with us the specific blessings you have been receiving through this broadcast and our online ministry. You may write to Deliverance Time, Cave of Eccles Assembly, 57 to 59 Public Road, Eccles, East Bank, Demerara, or you may email us at EcclesAG, all one word, all lowercase, EcclesAG@gmail.com. Also, we have WhatsApp numbers on which you can contact us. And those numbers are 613-2024, 613-2024, and 624-8858, 624-8858. Call us as well on numbers 233-2124 and 233-2982 should you need any further spiritual help. Those numbers again are 233-2124 and 233-2982. Stay tuned and be blessed.
Ooh. was just a child when I felt the Savior leading. I was drawn to what I could not understand. And for the cause of Christ, I have spent my days believing that what it had me be is who I am. As I've come to see the weaker side of me, I realize this grace is what I'll need. When sin demanded justice for my soul, mercy said no. Life and death stood face to face. Darkness tried to steal my heart away. Thank you, Jesus. Mercy said no. From the cross he built a bridge to set us free. Oh, but deep within the hearts, there is still a war that rages. And makes a sacrifice so hard to see. As midnight fell on crucifixion day, the as evil tried to stop redemption's flow, mercy said no.
I'm reading one verse of scripture found in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 22 is that verse. It reads, "For as in Adam all die, even so in Christ shall all be made alive." Genesis chapter 3 is the tragic record of the fall of man.
and the introduction of evil within the human race. The word Genesis actually means beginnings. It is therefore not surprising that in this first book of the Bible, we find the beginning of so many things: hatred, murder, violence, etc. We also have the beginning of the human species. Sir, according to the biblical account, the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul. Genesis chapter 2 and verse 7. Adam came from the hands of his creator, a perfect human being. In fact, throughout Genesis chapters 1 and 2, referring to God's creative activities, the Bible says, "And God saw that it was good." Over and over, that phrase or that statement occurs, "And God saw that it was good." The same could be said of Adam. He was perfect. Adam was created in the image of God, and that means that he was created with the capacity to reflect God's character in his love, patience, forgiveness, kindness, faithfulness, and so on. Adam was also created in the image of God in the sense of being endowed with reason, creativity, speech, and intelligence. Adam, may I remind you, friend, was given the mandate to name all the animals, including the monkey. I think it is very important for us to make that distinction between Adam the man and the animals which got their names from him. So Adam was made in the image and likeness of God. We were all made in God's image. And this fact provides a solid basis for self-worth. Hear me, friend. Human worth is not based on possessions, achievements, physical attractiveness, or public acclaim. Human worth is based on being made in God's image. Because we bear God's image, we can feel positive about ourselves. So criticizing or downgrading ourselves or others is criticizing what God has made and the abilities he has given. Unfortunately, the image of God in man was marred by sin. Genesis chapter 3 gives us a vivid account of how man fell into sin and degradation. This chapter is a blow-by-blow commentary, perhaps I should say a ball-by-ball commentary, of how evil entered the human race. Now, let me hasten to tell you, friend, that sin is the root cause of all the evils which plague our homes, our societies, and our nations. Friend of mine, I respectfully submit this morning that we will never get very far in dealing with social problems until we recognize and deal with the problem of sin. Sin, my friend, is a universal problem. It affects small countries as well as large states. It blights the rich and the poor. Sin defiles the educated and the uneducated. It troubles all mankind in spite of race, color, or creed. Paul in his letter to the Galatians advised that the scripture hath concluded all under sin. To the Romans he wrote, "All have sinned and come short of the glory of God." Centuries ago, the prophet Isaiah lamented, "All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way, and the Lord hath laid upon him," that is, Jesus Christ, "the iniquity of us all." Perhaps you're saying, "Preacher, I was raised in a Christian home. My parents were very strict and religious. From a tender age, I have been attending church. I've been visiting the temple or the mosque." I am very devoted to my family and kind to neighbors and friends. I don't steal or use profane language. I am a decent, law-abiding citizen, friend of mine. That may be true, but it does not erase the fact that all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. The psalmist was right and spoke for all of us when he said, I was shapen in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. Make no mistake, my friend, the disease of sin has plagued all mankind. According to Genesis chapter 3, the origin of sin in humanity is attributed to Satan. According to the biblical record, Satan evidently took control of a serpent and used it as an instrument in his work of tempting Eve to disobey. And listen to me, friends. Never forget this. Satan is real, and he is out to bring you down, to destroy you. You may think you are having a good time, young man. In fact, you may even be having a good time. But my friend, if those good times are at the expense of your relationship with God, if in order to have those good times you must leave God out of your plans and activities, you will realize someday that you were deceived by the devil. Satan is a deceiver. In the Garden of Eden, he deceived Eve. In chapter 3, we have the account of a masterful display of Satan's deceptive tactics. He was very crafty in his approach. He succeeded in getting Eve to question the word of God. Listen to me, sir. God has given to us his word for our guidance and our protection. Paul said to Timothy in 2 Timothy chapter 3 and verse 16, that all scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. Paul also told Timothy in that same chapter that the scriptures are given to make us wise unto salvation through faith, which is in Christ Jesus. And listening, friend, I urge you to give heed to the word of God this morning. Do not turn a deaf ear to the preaching of the gospel. Listen to what God is saying to you this morning through this radio program. You can never go wrong obeying the voice of God and living your life to please him. Be not deceived, says the scriptures. God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. For he that soweth to his flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption, but he that soweth to the Spirit shall of the Spirit reap life everlasting. Eve sowed to the flesh. She thought that life would become better if she could be like God, as the devil suggested. She was deceived, and friend of mine, those who think that they can flout God's orders and do their own thing must be reminded of the dreadful consequences of a life of disobedience to God and his word. The psalmist warned us in the first psalm that the Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish. The Bible says in Genesis 3 and verse 6, when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was pleasant to the eyes, and a tree to be desired to make one wise, she took of the fruit thereof, and did eat, and gave also unto her husband with her, and he did eat. And friends, that simple act of disobedience plunged not only Adam and Eve, but the entire human race into sin and misery. However, the good news is that Jesus came to save us. Yes, he came from heaven to earth to show the way. From the earth to the cross, our debts to pay. From the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. And that's why we lift his name on high on this broadcast. The word says in our text, for as in Adam all die, even so in Christ shall all be made alive. Today, friends, I urge you to turn your life over to Jesus if you have not done so as yet. He will deliver you out of the hand of Satan. He will set you free from those habits that are destroying your life. Let us pray.
Father, we thank you for the cross of Jesus Christ and its significance and relevance today. We thank you that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. We ask you to stretch forth your hand. We pray, O God, that you will save, you will heal, and you will deliver from every form of satanic bondage. We thank you right now that the blood of Jesus Christ was shed on the cross to redeem us from sin and all the dreadful consequences of sin. And that's why today we join with the apostle in declaring, God forbid that I should glory save in the cross. Thank you for touching each of us and all of us today. In Jesus' name, amen. Friends, it was certainly a joy having you with us on the Deliverance Time broadcast today. And we do look forward to having you join us next week at the same time for another program of Deliverance Time. Until the Lord richly bless you, everyone.
Oh,